I've had some comments recently on the screw type stitch length adjuster video that people with 99s are having problems getting the adjustment mechanism back together. And that's because there is no hole with a plate on the back of the pillar like there is on a 66 or a 15 or any of the vibrating shuttle machines. So fear not, I'm going to show you how to do it. All right, something you're going to need, or something that's going to make life a lot easier, is this style magnet on a stick. It's a smaller magnet on the end and a bit of an articulated head. That's going to make life a lot easier, as will a pair of tweezers with a pointed bent tip. All right, we're going to start by putting the fork with the bearing back in the machine, getting the fork back on the cam and resting that end back on its pillar and just dropping the eccentric screw in place. All right, no adjustment, just getting it there just to hold things. Okay, that's the easy part. Now we have our screw adjuster. We can back that out just a little bit. Now what I have found works well is we take the piece of the mechanism that's the problem child, the block, magnet like that, get her in the hole, and kind of maneuver her around a little bit. You might have to turn the shaft a little. Just maneuver it around. Oops, slipped. I'm gonna give myself a little bit more meat here. Okay, get her back in. And get that pivot point back up to the block. Now here you'll see I need to get that screw in a little bit more. So I'm going to back that out, get that over the slot in the on the screw, and then I can just swing this around and pivot that in place and use my tweezers to get the screw aligned. Okay? And then it's just a matter of setting up our lock washer. Actually, let's get that straight again. There we go. Our lock washer and our bolt, putting it in the hole, and there we go. Now it's in and running it down. That's all there is to it. And of course, then put the nut back on the other side of the eccentric screw and do the adjustments that are required on the eccentric screw for the fore and aft position of the feed dogs inside the needle plate. But that's all there is to it. Get yourself one of these. These are cheap. These are like $1.98, you know, at Harbor Freight. And I keep a couple of them on the bench. Use that on the tab portion to maneuver it in place. I'm seeing roughly two full threads, closer to three full threads exposed right here. And that's where I was able to get it in, no problem. So try that as your setting. It's really not that difficult. It's sort of like the same way you get to Carnegie Hall. Practice, practice, practice. But I hope this helps. And keep the comments coming, and I'll keep on trying to figure out better ways to describe this stuff for you. But thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.